Now that we know what CPI is, how to calculate it, and how to calculate inflation, let's talk about how to use the information in our everyday life. I'm going to start with a personal example. I have this conversation with my dad every time I move or purchase something. My dad likes to remind me about how much he spent on the same thing back in the day. My dad lived in the United States in the mid-80s, so that's the time frame he refers to as back in the day. I remember when I first moved to Cincinnati, my father was curious about how much I was paying for rent. I told him I paid $950. He couldn't believe it. He was convinced I was overpaying because back in the day, he paid $350 for the same size apartment. Me being an economist, I remind him of this concept called inflation. I'm not overpaying. The difference is because of inflation. My dad was still convinced that I'm overpaying much more than inflation would suggest. How many of you have had a similar experience? Parents, grandparents, comparing the cost of the service or goods from back in the day to what you are paying now. And they suggest that you're being taken for a ride. First, we have to be clear that the change in price of one good is not inflation. Inflation is an increase in the overall price of goods and services. We saw in the previous episode that it is possible for some goods to go down in price and we still have inflation overall. Now that we have gotten this technical definition out of the way, let's see if my dad's correct or if I'm correct. In 1985, my dad paid $350 for a two-bedroom apartment in the US. In 2015, I was paying $950 for a two-bedroom apartment. My dad thinks that the amount I'm paying is higher than what inflation would suggest. To see who is correct, we have two options. We can discount what I'm paying and turn it into 1985 prices. Or take what my dad was paying and convert it to $2015. I'm going to use option two. I'm going to take 1985 rent. I'm going to convert it to $2015 to see what the rent payment my dad was making would be in $2015 if inflation was the only factor. If I convert my dad's 1985 rent to $2015 and it is a lower amount than what I am paying, then my dad is correct. If it is equal or higher, then I'm correct. So let's see who's right. The equation we will use is as follows. The value in the earlier period multiplied by the ratio of CPI in the future period divided by the CPI in the earlier period will give us the value in the future period. In this example, we take the rent from 1985, multiply it by the price level or the CPI of 2015, divided by the price level in 1985. That mathematical outcome will tell us what the rent should be in 2015 solely based on inflation. We know the rent in 1985 was $350. But we do not know the price level in 2015 or 1985. We can use Fred, so let's look up CPI for 1985 and 2015. The CPI in 1985 is 107, and in 2015 it was 237. So now we have all the information to prove my dad wrong. $350 multiplied by 237 divided by 107, the answer is $775. So my dad's right. Solely based on inflation, what cost $350 in 1985 should cost $775 in 2015, while I was paying $950 for what should cost me $775. So CPI allows us to convert dollars from one period to another based on the price level. It allows us to compare across time. We can compare the price of a 12-ounce can of Coke in 1942 that cost 5 cents then to what we pay today. The CPI in 1942 was 16 and the CPI in 2019 was 255. The same can of Coke would cost 5 cents times 255 divided by 16. That equals 80 cents. Are you paying more than 80 cents for a can of Coke? If so, the price of Coke has increased at a rate higher than inflation. 1 pound of Oreos in 1922 cost 32 cents, and the CPI then was 17. The same package today should cost 0.32 times 255 divided by 17. That's $4.80. What's the price of 1 pound of Oreo at the grocery store today? Check it out and tell me what it is. If it's less than $4.80, then the price of Oreos increased at a rate lower than inflation. We can use the same equation to compare across geographies. We know that different parts of the country have different price levels or cost of living. Many of you might get job offers in different cities, and you'll want to compare the cost of living. In 2019, the average NKU College of Business graduate received a salary of $45,000. As you know, most of our graduates stay in Cincinnati metro area. Let us say that you are considering moving to San Francisco. How much would you have to be paid in San Francisco to have the same lifestyle as you do in Cincinnati when making $45,000? Obviously, there is a difference in tax rates too, but let's just assume we are interested solely on CPI differences. We can use this equation. Wage in San Francisco is equal to wage in Cincinnati multiplied by CPI in San Francisco divided by CPI in Cincinnati. Using Fred, we can find the CPI in Cincinnati in 2019. Then the CPI in San Francisco in 2019. Our equation is $45,000 multiplied by 455 divided by 230. The wage in San Francisco would have to be $89,021 for you to have the same lifestyle as you did in Cincinnati. So now you know how to compare across geographies with different cost of living. You can find websites that make this conversion for you, but now you know what they are doing in the back end of it. Another area inflation can be helpful is when negotiating wage increases. Let's assume that you apply for a new job and you get it. Your contract tells you that your wage will increase at a rate of 2% per year. This increase will only be nominal increase in wages. You should be interested in real increases in your wages. You would want to know how much your wage increases after taking inflation into consideration. On average, the US has a 2% inflation rate per year. Therefore, if your wage is increasing by 2% per year and inflation is 2%, your real wage is not increasing. Wage increases would have to be higher than inflation for you to have a real increase in your living standards. The equation to that is real growth is equal to nominal growth minus inflation. We have seen how we can use CPI and inflation to help us make better economic decisions. We now know how to compare across time. We can compare across geographies. We could compare nominal versus real growth rates. In the next video, we will talk about the cost of inflation to society in a little bit more detail. See you next class.